Hello everybody and welcome back to Okami. It is me, Ralphie993, and in the last episode we finished up all our backtracking. And now we are back in Shinshu Field. And with this Kawagami statue, we're gonna reach ourselves a new area to figure out what the heck is going on with those storm clouds and see if we can reach the far north where all the evil swirliness of all the bad guys we fought have been racing towards. Which is kinda scary. We probably don't want all of that combining into one dark force. But let's be honest, bad things happen, and that's probably what's going to happen. I'm just going to bypass that demon gate for the moment, because if we run all the way to the end of this upper cliff area, we got a clover over here. Clover, clover, clover. And actually, while we're up here, because this is still an area of Shinshu Field, there's no stripe beads or anything up there. Up here, it's purely all treasure. You can see Bakugami? I don't even remember their names anymore. The pig god, the cherry bomb, god of cherry bomb, god of explosions. Oh, we got another clover over here. Oh, that's cool. Actually, let's see here. Can we get ourselves anything? Any sort of praise upgrades? We got 477. So let's get ourselves more life. Because we don't really need anything else. So we got 15 things of life. Only 5 more left to go. Now, demon gate ahead. Alright, Shinshu Field, we got more demons. Kill it with our sword. Give it a gale storm, or not. Give it a gale storm. Get its demon fangs. Yeah, with our glaives too, especially this. Where are we going? Weemo, I don't even know where you're going. Oh, well, that thing's dead. But one hit, and these red imps are dead. That's powerful. That's power. I like power. Alright, you die too? I'd love it. These guys are, though, still pretty strong for a smaller imp. No, get back down here. Let's blow that away. And one more hit for that guy. Definitely aerial attacks don't do as much damage as regular attacks. Oh, by the way, that's the Z move for the glaives. I don't tend to use it because you kind of get stuck in the ground a little bit and it takes a little while for Amaterasu to recover from that move, but it's pretty cool nonetheless. Oh, we have all the sleeping bunnies. Well, let's give the sleeping bunnies a midnight snack. Well, actually, it's probably not midnight. It just recently became night. Like, just before I started the episode, it switched from day to night. So it's probably more like a 10 p.m. snack. And they're probably going to have heartburn now. Or at least very upset tummies. I can't eat very, very close to like bedtime, because I feel like absolute crap afterwards if I do. And oh yeah, just the thought of it. It's like I usually try not to eat after 8 o'clock anyways, just to kind of like reduce, you know, the amount that I eat and prevent snacking and such. But like, even if I do, it's kind of like ugh. My roommates, they'll eat like dinners at like 10 p.m. or something like that, and it's like, how could you eat like a whole thing of like macaroni and stuff just before bed? Or I guess they probably stay up a little bit later, but it's just like, oh, I could not do that. Like, the thought of like going to sleep with such a full stomach just makes me feel queasy. Alright, let's get rid of the skulls around this guy. Good. We'll just wail on him. Anybody else who gets in my way will probably have me kill them. Like, almost. Oh, I want his demon fangs. Please don't do that. And one hit for you. Demon fangs for me. Oh, there's another guy here. Well, that's a little closer comfort. Kill the skulls. They hit me. It was probably gonna happen. Don't you look at me. The skulls always, like, their eyes follow you too, which is kind of creepy. Everywhere you go. Demon fangs from you. Demon fangs from you. Suddenly singing. Oh, well. Hopefully don't mind damage. Did I take damage? I did not take damage. Oh, I guess the skulls hit me. Never mind, I did. But more bunnies? I kind of want there to be more chickens. Okay, I think we've found most of the chickens already. I don't know about anybody else, but I think chickens are adorable. I don't know, like, they're not, but they are in a weird way. Their little cluckiness, they're like, I know it's a cartoon chicken, but we recently saw Despicable Me 2, and there's a chicken and it's adorable. That might be a spoiler, but not really. That's like saying there's birds in movies. Granted, chicken is a bird too, but yeah, chickens are adorable in any way. I love animated chickens, they're so cute. And this has been here for ages, but nobody knows what it's for. There are many things like that in Nippon. No one knows when they were built or even who built them. But I suppose people have more important things to think about. Clearly. Yeah, I got a big, I don't even know what that is. It's like, maybe a sword? It looks more like a astronomer's setup or something like that. But not a telescope. It seems to be a ginormous sword of some kind. But hey, we've seen swords before, and what did we do with them? We lit them on lightning. I wonder if that's 9 strike again. Let's see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. No, that's 7. It only has 7 prongs. Oh, but it opens. There's a door on the other side that I did not look at before. But guess what? There was a door on the other side. And now, it is open. It's not there. There it is. Ami, do you know what this hold leads to? You know, there was a foul smoke rising from Ninetales, which flew off to the northern lands. That's what's waiting for us on the other side of this tunnel. Anyway, what's up with that creepy lightning? I'm getting a bad feeling about this. And Ami just goes anyways. Shh, I don't need your warning, Issun. It's doing our own thing. Oh. This is kind of ominous. It's all quiet. Oh, we're stuck. A dark, dark tunnel. It's kind of neat how, like, this is how you get to the Northern Lands. Is by this, like, tunnel that, like, I can imagine people who used to, like, traverse it, people who lived in the north who used this tunnel as a safe and probably kind of warm and, well, unless you had enemies come in here, it probably wouldn't be very safe anymore. You'd be kind of screwed, actually. But it's a nice little, like, kind of underground passage in order to get there. But we are in Kamui. Kamui? Kamui. I don't know. Brr! Is it cold here or what? How could anywhere be so darn cold? I don't remember it ever snowing this hard before. I skipped that text. Listen, Ami, I'm gonna hunker down in this fur coat of yours. You try to find us some shelter from this nasty blizzard. Ooh, yeah, definitely. It looks chilly here. Very cold. Granted, Ami probably got it. There's an origin mirror there. We got fire. Somehow it's not cold enough for fire to still persist. Can we light things on fire? Not that. But you can light things on fire, but. Ooh. That definitely looks like where it's coming from. There's a house there, so maybe we'll just tuck ourselves in there. Or, you know, get interrupted by enemies. Oh, it's a creepy mask. Alright, so these guys are called Namahages, I think? I don't know, whenever I see the word, I think Namahage was like, you know what, that's not the same way they've always been pronouncing things in this game. So, these guys are basically powered up versions of imps and guardians. We got blade ones here, these are the red ones, like red imps. But what is their... Their four finishers are Gale Storm. Gale Storm. Gale Storm. Okay, well, you know what, that was 3 times. What more can I do? Not much. There's giant ravens flying outside my window, and it's kind of creepy. But there we go, Gale Storm. They only give us, like, 1 or 2, though, so. They don't, like, give us 2 like the Headless Guardians do, or just guard- Don't hit me! Don't- No, okay. Wiimote, I would love it if you would just blow me some wind. And not be a pain in the butt. But yes, both of these guys have Gale Storm as their foil finishers. And the Blade ones give us 2. The other ones only give us 1. But yeah, so it's like, it's something like, we'll see how it's written when I check out the bestiary. Really quick. But, so let's see here. Bestiary. So we have, yeah, see, it's like Nama, I think it's Namahage is how it's pronounced, but again, whenever I see it, I think like Namahage or something like that. But Namahage are the embodiment of loneliness inherent in snowy lands, raising a terrifying voice to seek out and attack living things. If you cross paths with one, you shall play dead. They regard the lazy as friends and will be lulled into a false sense of security. Okay. And then we have the other ones we fought here, the Blade Namahage. They say that you should play dead if confronted by a Namahage, but it can be quite fearsome to hide in plain sight of an armed one. A legend tells of a samurai that tried to banish Namahage. He attacked its blade with a nearby brush while it was distracted. Without its weapon, it grew afraid and left, promising to reform. Kind of scary looking. But yeah, they're just that same kind of class. Anyways, yeah, let's get out of this blizzard. Head to this house here. Looks warm and toasty. Brr! Look, fire! Fire! Guess we're not gonna freeze to death after all. Kind of weird, there's just a fire in here. Ooh. What's your problem, Ami? I'm allowed to relax in front of the fire, ain't I? Yikes! You! Oh, that's a sword. That's pointy. See that, Ami? I'm not talking about that silly mask. I mean his sword. That puppy's a bona fide masterpiece. Where'd he go? He was just waiting out here for us. What if we never escaped? What if we never left the building? He would just be out here freezing. Looks like he means business. He's not really friendly to begin with. Alright, so basically, Veil of Mist, always your friend. Attack, 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 attack. Just, actually, he's kind of easy, this guy. Just keep wailing on him. Occasionally, his sword will light up blue, and it's kind of like an attack that he's gonna start doing. Can you land so I can hit you, please, sir? Thank you. What are you doing? Put that sword down. Alright, what did he summon? He summoned little swords. We can take care of those. We've done this with Waka and Rao before, and that stuns him. So, but keep wailing on him. Power slash. Okay, are you summoning the same things again? He is. We can take care of those again. Not if they go out of sync, but he's still stunned, so whatever. And there's a few times he'll summon his sword, like a blue light from his sword, and those little icicles will show up. Or sometimes his sword will have a power, and he'll kind of do like a dash attack. Like he's doing right now, maybe? Or no, he's just rolling out of our way. But basically, just keep hitting him. Use Veil of Mist. Slows him down. Oh, he's got more icicles. Don't hit me, please. I don't appreciate that. I am lacking clothes. I am naked. Infinity Stone. Stop summoning these things. He didn't summon them this much in my practice file. He seems to be very happy. Oh my god, I'm frozen! I'm frozen! Thankfully, there's fire nearby. But, stop it. Come back here, you sir. How dare you attack me! It's okay. Just keep wailing on him. Again, he's not that difficult. Keep using Veil of Mist so that you can keep hitting him for a longer period of time. He hit me again? He got me on like the backhand of a sword or something. No, can you just stop? Can we just, there we go. Attack them before they come after us. But oh. Wow, okay, so this is a special kind of person. Here we have his beast form, I suppose. A little bit more difficult. He's got the same kind of like spinny-ish attack as the Satomi Canine Warriors do. Basically, keep using Veil of Time. Fight him like you would the dogs, but he's a lot easier than the dogs. Just, yeah, keep hitting him. And keep hitting him. Eventually, you'll wear him down. I don't think he gets stunned very often, though, in beast form, but... Oh, maybe he just did right there. Alright, power slash him. Oh, that did lots of damage. Alright, keep using Veil of Mist. He does have other kinds of attacks that he will use. We'll see if he does it. If not, I'll just tell you what he does. Oh, he's gonna, like, dash attack me? Ouch! That was silly of you. I know how to fight people like you. I just whacked my computer with my Wiimote. Whoops. They truly say, make sure you have enough space before you start doing this. He's not going to do his other attack before I kill him. Oh, there it is. Okay, he's going to release these, like, ice dogs. So basically, use the fire around you to attack them. And... and you stun them once. Okay, that's not going to help Wiimote. But you stun them once with fire and then attack them again while they're stunned again, and that will basically eliminate them. Also, once he gets all icy like this, if you use fire on him, it'll also cancel out his attack. So that's pretty much all to this guy. Almost done with him. I kind of just want to ignore these guys, but I'm going to get rid of them anyways because they can be a pain in the butt, but hey, they're stunned now. Can you stop jumping around? I just want to end you. Oh, come on. You're pretty much done. Just give up. There we go. The rest die with him. Not bad, White One. I am Oki, warrior of the Oina tribe. Oina warrior, Oki. You are obviously not from our tribe. And I can see that you are no mere wolf, either. What name do you go by? This here is Amaterasu, the great savior of Nippon. But enough about that. Why'd you have to go out and attack us? And what are you doing with that sword in that first place? Oh, I see you have a Ponko with you. Wait, is that Issun? I haven't seen you in around in ages. Must be nice to be able to roam Nippon on the back of a wolf, huh? I heard you got tired of painting and ran from this land in disgust about a year ago. So why'd you come back? Did you have second thoughts? Why you? I don't know who you two think you are, but you're nothing like the legendary Shiranui and the pint-sized warrior. Hey, we're getting there! That's kind of rude. I just kicked your ass and you're insulting me? Bah! Put a cork in it, will ya? Why don't you start by telling us why you have that sword? This sword? I have this sword because the time to wield it has come. What? As you well know, Kamui is a harsh land covered in snow and ice. And the monsters that infest the region only make our life worse. Yet we, the Oina tribe, have managed to survive to this day. It is because the sacred Ezofuji mountains have watched over us. However, our mothers and protectors, our most sacred of mountains, have been taken over by those demons. Yes, I speak of the twin demons, Lechku and Nechku. They had been imprisoned at the twin summits of Ezofuji, but they suddenly broke free one day and began their deadly assault upon the land of Kamui. Snowstorms grew more intense, transforming Kamui into a frozen wasteland. Those demons are back? Many of our tribe have been killed by their relentless attacks. It was as if they roamed our land in search of something, but they mercilessly slaughtered all the Oina they came across. The good earth is losing its power and its soul. Without these gifts of the gods, Kamui will become uninhabitable. I must slay those wretched demons now, before it is too late. What about the villagers? They should be battling the cold that blasts down from Ezofuji. After all, our village lies at their base. It is only a matter of time before Kamui becomes an icy tomb. Oh, that's kind of depressing. An icy tomb? Then what are you doing out here with that guardian sword? Why did you bring it out of the village? Did I not say the time to use the sword has come? You've heard of the prophecy of salvation, have you not? The wall of ice shall shatter and open the way to the heavens when Katoni, the guardian sword, glows silver. It means that when this sword glows silver, ridding the village of this abominable blizzard will be child's play. sword's gonna start glowing? Yes. Makotone will not wake until it has tasted more monster blood. So I will continue slaying the foul beasts wherever they may be. Okay, not us, not us, we're not foul. Until Katone lights our way to victory. But his time was good. Damage he hit us? Maybe a few times. I didn't think so. Anyways, well, looks like he wants to talk more. We'll talk with him in the next episode. So I thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you then.